Hello, good evening, Bob Miramar once again in our Facebook Live broadcast, and it is our prayer and it is our desire that God's hand would continue to bless your life and show you His good works, and He would literally demonstrate His loving kindness and His faithfulness upon your life. Good evening to everybody coming from Manila, Philippines, and saying hello and good evening. This is the Day of Hope in the Lord Jesus Christ Live. And so we will have to partake with this specific part of the scriptures that is found in Proverbs, in the book of Proverbs chapter 3, from verse 21 up to 26. And let this be our base of confidence and be the wonderful foothold of our faith. Those who love life, those who love your family, your ministry, your business, the work that you do for the name of the Lord. Tonight, hi, hello, my classmate, Pastora Terry Broqueza. Good evening, and thank you for saying hello and waving here. My classmate, Agnes Formentera Montehermoso, hi, hello. Glenn Balista, Darren Mendoza, hi. And good evening to all of you. Raven Mangalindan, hello. And God bless, yeah, God bless Pastora Terry, your family, your loved ones, and your ministry. Going back to Proverbs chapter 3, verse 21 to 26, it says, "My son, let them not depart from your eyes. Keep sound wisdom and discretion, so they will be life to your soul and grace to your neck. Then you will walk safely in your way, and your foot will not stumble. When you lie down, you will not be afraid. Yes, you will lie down, and your sleep will be sweet. Do not be afraid of sudden terror or of trouble from the wicked when it comes, for the Lord will be your confidence and will keep your foot from being caught." For the Lord will be your confidence and will keep your foot from being caught, meaning from being stumbled by the way of Satan, temptations and sinfulness and wickedness and all His strategies on earth. What are the things that the Lord says we should keep and not depart our eyes from? Verse 19, it says, "The Lord by wisdom founded the earth, by understanding established the heavens. By His knowledge the depths were broken up, and clouds dropped down the dew." So, ang ibig sabihin po niyan, mga kaibigan, ang karunungan, ang kaalaman, at ang kaunawaan. Si King Solomon man din ay dumalangin sa Panginoon in the book of 1 Kings chapter 3. Sabi niya, "O dear God, because you have chosen me to rule over your people after my father, your servant, King David." Sabi niya, "Give me wisdom and the ability on how to rule this vast number of your people excellently or in a manner that you want me how to rule over them." And so the Lord answered him in a dream and said, "Solomon, son of my servant King David, I've heard your prayer. Since you did not ask for fame and wealth, treasures and the heads of your enemy, I will give you what you have asked for, and I will also give you what you did not ask for. Ganyan ho ang isipan ng Panginoon when you come before Him and trust in the Lord. You will never miss anything that you think, anything that you have cared in your heart, anything, everything that you care for, hihigitan niya ng Panginoon. Kasi kung nais mo nang magtagumpay, nais mo nang magandang buhay, nais mo nang kapayapaan, nais mo nang pag-angat ng iyong uri ng standard ng paglilingkod o pamumuhay o kaya yung family mo, gusto mo mag-improve yung kanilang kalalagayan, so you are doing everything, ginagawa mong araw yung mga gabi, nagpapatulo ka ng pawis sa pagtatrabaho, sinisikap mo sa sarili mo na maibigay mo sa pamilya mo yung pinaka the best. Alam niyo ho, yan din yung gustong gusto ng Panginoon. At even before God created man, He already had given everything that man and all the people of the world would have to need during their life. And also, God had planned very much better place to live for humankind. But because of that first wicked act and transgressions against the Lord, nagkaroon tuloy ng two types of death, yung separation from the presence of God, and then yung death in the flesh, yun yung pinaka naging bunga sa kasalanang nagawa. At ang Garden of Eden, yung potentiality of a very wonderful life that is filled of everything that a person should need of during his life, during her life, ay sinabi tuloy ng Panginoong Diyos na sumpain ang lupa, and from the sweat of the brows ay magtatrabaho yung tao bago makakakain, and then pag nanganganak ang babae ay mailalagay sa bingit ng danger yung kanyang buhay, all because of the sinfulness and transgressions. But nonetheless, let me tell you, ganun pa man ang nangyari, ang Panginoon ho ay gumawa pa rin ng mga higit na mas dakilang kaparaanan upang iligtas ang tao mula sa kasawian. Kung kaya ho, ang dapat lamang gawin ng bawat isa sa atin ay yakapin ang salita ng Diyos, yakapin ang pagpapahayag ng Diyos ng dakilang layunin ng pagmamahal, at ibinigay niya ang kanyang bugtong na anak na si Jesus, at siya ay nabayubay sa krus ng Kalbaryo, nagpatigi siya ng kanyang banal na dugo upang i-provide sa atin, una, ang kapatawaran ng ating kasalanan, buong katauhan, sa buong sanlibutan, sa bawat henerasyon, ay ginawa ni Jesus ang kanyang offering once and for all to empower each person when he comes to know the Lord Jesus Christ and accept Him to be his Lord and Savior, his soul will be saved. And yung mga blessing ay pinangako ng Panginoon na He will keep us, just like this one, na by wisdom and by understanding, by knowledge, all right, of the living God, we have to grow. Parang yung pinag-usapan natin in the book of Ephesians chapter 4, at yung pinag-usapan natin sa 1 Peter, at pinag-usapan natin sa 2 Peter sa mga previous broadcast natin, that we should stand up against all the work of the enemy now, coming from our victorious position in the Lord Jesus Christ. And so therefore, let us grow in wisdom, let us grow in the knowledge of God, and let us grow in understanding the Word of God. And this part of the book of Proverbs says, "My son, let them not depart from your eyes." You always make yourself remember God's wisdom, God's understanding, and also God's knowledge. And we are now gifted with the secret things Ang sabi ni Apostle Paul, the things which been kept in secret long time ago, but now had been revealed to those who believe in the Lord by the power of the Holy Spirit. We can understand the Word of God. And the Word of God is readily available, and it is printed out, the Old Testament and the New Testament, to be our guide. So, good evening, everybody. It is God's love, His grace to us, that those who accept and believe in the Lord Jesus Christ, the Lord Jesus Christ gave them the authority to become children of God. With such authority, the Lord, by the power of the Holy Spirit, empowers our understanding, giving us knowledge. And from the knowledge of the Word of God, we shall derive heavenly wisdom on how to live on earth. That's it. How to connect the dots, right? So, by believing God, accepting His love, embracing His faithfulness, by means of surrendering our life to Jesus Christ, we will begin to understand who God is, though we cannot completely, fully understand His character trait. But nonetheless, what is written in the Bible, what God wants us to do, and how God would want to see in us how we operate in life every day, trusting and confident in Him. The Lord will increase our knowledge as we absorb the blessings of the Word. Kaya sa 2 Timothy chapter 3, verse 16 to 17, the Word of God is inspired. It is the breath of God. And it is useful to correct, to rebuke, to teach, to reprove, meaning to discipline our way, to teach us the right way, so that we can walk on the right path. And in the book of Psalms, the Word of God is the lamp unto our feet, the light unto our path. That the moment we carry on with the Word, oh hallelujah, you are beginning to absorb life, because the Word of God was with God, and the Word of God is God, and the Word of God came to earth, for it is the light of man, it is the life, light and life. And then the Word of God, He became flesh. And John the Beloved writes in John chapter 1 verse 14, and the Word of God became flesh, at nakita namin ang kanyang kaluwalhatian, nakasama namin siya, and His name is Jesus Christ. So therefore, ang sabi ng book of Proverbs, do not let them depart from your eyes. Keep sound wisdom. And so we can keep and live by good, godly discretion, so they will become life to your soul and grace to your neck. Then you will walk safely in your way, and your foot will not stumble. When you lie down, you will not be afraid. Yes, you will not. You will lie down, and your sleep will be sweet. Do not be afraid of sudden terror, nor of trouble from the wicked when it comes. For the Lord will be your confidence and will keep your foot from being caught. There are times life would come to a place of momentarily trials and sufferings. That is the reason why I would always remember the story of Joseph, the son of Jacob. All his half-brothers, the sons of Jacob, from Joseph's auntie niya yun eh. Kaya, mga half-brothers niya yung sila Judah, yung mga nagpahirap sa kanya, at siya ay dumaan sa matinding mga pagsubok, mga kabigatan, tinapon sa isang dried up na well, pagkatapos ibinenta sa mga Egyptian trader, nakarating sa Egypt, nabili ni Potiphar, the administrator ni Pharaoh, the king of Egypt, and he was serving faithfully in that household, and Potiphar had trusted Joseph so much until the wife of Potiphar, Mrs. Potiphar, had wicked intentions, dirty proposals to him, and when he rejected, that's it. You will never be caught. Okay? When Joseph rejected, sometimes talaga pagka gumawa ka ng pangit, mapapahama ka. Tulad ni Joseph, siya naman gumawa ng mabuti, niwasan niya yung karumaldumal na proposal, na pahamak pa din. But during his lowest parts of his life, that's where Joseph had learned and matured enough in his faith. And then God provided him for a wonderful, not an escape, but he was released from prison. And then the story goes like that. Joseph had become the right hand of Pharaoh of Egypt, the most powerful nation, the most powerful government in country during his time. Oh, God, thank you, Jesus. May mga momentary sufferings, may mga momentary downs in sacrifices, lowest portions of life, but the lower Joseph got, the higher he became. In highly urbanized cities like Makati, Pasig, Manila, Quezon City, and the likes, New York, Bangkok, Singapore, Hong Kong, cities in Japan, kung saan prevalent yung mga earthquake. Alam niyo, pag gumagawa na sila ng mga high-rise na mga buildings, pag gumagawa sila ng mataas na mga gusali, kailangan mas malalim yung foundation. Because the deeper the foundation is, the higher the building can be. So friends, do not be afraid if you suffer sometimes. Do not be afraid if God would allow you to be into the lowest part of your life. The most important thing is that you fix your eyes in Jesus. You fix your eyes up ahead, up there in heaven, and trust God and trust the Lord. If you fix your eyes, if you look unto Jesus, every bad situations will be turned into good and blessed situations. Look at the three friends of Daniel. Look at Daniel himself. They were captivated. They were exiled because of the wickedness of their leaders, the wickedness of their country, of their nation Israel, before the eyes of the Lord. God knows how to keep His promises. God knows how to keep His holy and divine intentions in His heart for you. Believe in the Lord. Fix your heart. Believe in the Lord. Fix your heart. Walk according to His ways. Ang sabi ng banal na kasulatan, do not turn to the right, do not turn to the left, but fix your eyes. And diretso lang ho. Tama ho yun. God will bless, God will hear, and God will be with us always. So ang sabi ng Bible, especially in Proverbs chapter 3 verse 26, ito po yung ating theme, the Lord is our confidence, the Lord is our strength, and there is no safest place in this world, wherever, but in the presence of the Lord, where He is moving and the place that He is with. For the Lord will be your confidence and will keep your foot from being caught. All right. So let us pray. Yesterday, Brother Charles Flores asked for us to pray for his pops and moms because kailangan bumababa yung blood sugar nila at lumakas ang kalang katawan. Ingatan sila ng Panginoon. Ngayon naman, yung mga relatives daw nila sa Davao ay naharap sa banta ng bagyong si Chering. Let us pray that God would keep our kababayans and also the gospel boat where our senior pastor and wife together with their companions are. Panalangin natin ang pag-iingat ng Panginoon sa kanila. And friends, ano man yung iyong personal na kalalagayan ngayon, do not be dismayed, do not be discouraged. Tayo lang ho. At sa iyong pagtayo ng iyong pananampalataya, titindig ang pananampalataya mo, why not come before the Lord, kneel down and pray. Oo, balik tayo doon sa pananalangin, balik tayo doon sa paglapit sa Panginoon, balik tayo doon sa pag-aaral ng kanyang salita. Sabi't kailangan natin na tumaas din po yung antas ng ating pagkakakilala sa Panginoon through how the Word of God describes Him and who He is and what He does and what He plans. And then by that, we can walk, we can live right according to His ways. When that happens, wisdom, understanding, and knowledge will really lead us to where God is working, to where God is present. Because His presence is already given to each person who believes in Him, but it has to be nourished. Our Christian life has to be nourished. It is just like a fruit-bearing tree na pag naitanim yung buto sa lupa, kailangan nating i-nurture yun, i-nourish natin yun, alagaan natin yun, lupa, i-cultivate natin yan para lumaking puno ito, hindi lang basta magmukhang puno, bagkos lumaking puno magmula sa pagiging maliit na halaman ito, at hindi lang basta lumaki at nagkaroon ng mayabong na lilim upang doon tayo mamamahinga, matulog, uminom ng tubig at kumain at mag-picnic o kaya mag-put up ng swing. Hindi lang ho yun, kundi yung puno ay nagbubunga. Ang pananampalataya ho ay ganon. Ang pananampalataya ho natin ay kailangang yumabong, lumaki ng isang punong, malaking-malaking puno na matibay sa lahat ng panahon, tag-araw man o tag-baha, tag-ulan, at magbubunga ng masagana. Alright? Magbubunga ng masagana. At hindi matatakot sa kung anumang mga panahon na dadating ang mga pagsubok. Psalms 91 verse 5, "You shall not be afraid of the terror by night, nor of the arrow that flies by day." Hallelujah. And 1 Peter 3:14 it says, "But even if you should suffer for righteousness' sake, you are blessed." Praise God. "And do not be afraid of their threats, nor be troubled." Kaya huwag ko kayong papayag na anong sinasabi na inyong naririnig at magpapagulo sa ating isipan. Just focus. Hold your horn up high in the Lord, for the Lord is our confidence. So friends, kung meron kang mga bagay na nakikitang mabigat, mahirap sa iyong buhay, andiyan yan ang Panginoon. Nangangarap ka ng magandang kabuhayan, magandang kinabukasan, naririyan ang Panginoon. Nangangarap ka na maging mahusay ang magiging takbo na iyong buhay at kung ikaw ay nagsuserve sa Lord, ang ministeryo sa Panginoon ay hindi lang basta status quo, kundi nag-i-improve, nagpo-progress ang iyong personal life in serving God. Believe in the Lord. Nandiyan ang Panginoon. Ano man yung mga kinakatakutan mo, do not be afraid anymore. Do not be dismayed and do not be discouraged, but be enthusiastic enough to do what God wants us to do, to serve Him, and also to be motivated. Be bold. Sabi ng Panginoon kay Josue, patay na si Moses, ang aking lingkod, ikaw na ang papalit sa kanya. So, don't be dismayed, don't be discouraged, but be bold. Kaya sabi ni Josue, kung nakikita ninyo ay hindi tama yung maglilingkod sa Panginoon, bahala kayo, pumili kayo ng sinong susundin niyo. Kung yung mga Diyos-Diyosang sinasamba ng mga Amoreo, mga Pariseo, mga Perizzites, mga Amorites, mga Jebusites, yung mga Panginoon ng ating mga kaaway, pumili na kayo ngayon sino yung inyong paglilingkuran. But as for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. The Lord is our confidence. No matter how many battles are waiting in line, but we will fight coming from our victorious position in the Lord Jesus Christ. Sapagkat ang lahat ng nagtitiwala sa Panginoon ay hindi mapapahiya. Ang lahat ng nagtitiwala sa Panginoon ay hindi pababayaan ng Panginoon na madulas, mahulog sa patibong ng Diablo. Shall we pray? Aming Ama na makapangyarihan sa lahat, nagpapasalamat po kami sa maikling sandali kung saan ay nagkakasama-sama kami. Kahit kami ay naririto sa magkakaiba-ibang mga lugar ng mundo, yung iba ay nasa ibayong dagat, sa iba't ibang sulok at panig ng daigdig, at kasama namin ngayon sa amin pong evening devotion, at yung iba naman ay nandito sa Manila, at ang iba naman ay naroon sa Davao, nasa Mindanao, nasa Kabisayaan, at nasa Luzon, Northern and Southern Central Luzon. Panginoon, ang iyong kamay ay hindi po maigli upang hindi ninyo mararating ang mga taong nagtitiwala sa inyo, lalo na yung mga sumusunod sa iyo, Panginoon, at yung kanilang mga mahal sa buhay, na ang sabi po ninyo, those who are faithful in you will keep them, hallelujah, as well as their children and the children of their children, you will keep them for all times. Those who believe in you will prosper them. So Lord, we pray, yung mga lugar sa Mindanao at sa Kabisayaan na nangangamba para po sa pagtama ng bagyong si Chedeng, Father God, we just rebuke that storm in the name of Jesus. Father, bring it up there higher and pass right away our area of responsibility, or otherwise, let it drop into the valleys and mountains na hindi naman tinitirahan ng mga tao at hindi naman pinagtatamnan ng kalamangasakahan, at mawawala ang malakas na pressure at buwelo nito. Sa pangalan ni Jesus, we rebuke you, spirit of destruction, in Jesus' name. Amen. Those who are sick and those who are greatly troubled, those whose hearts are no longer having that capable to sleep good and deep because of their problems, Lord, touch them. Give them your spirit bringing shalom, kapanatagan, kapayapaan ay sumakanila, Panginoon. Yung mga isipang binabakbakan ng maraming trouble, Lord, pagpalain mo sa pangalan ni Jesus, sapagkat kami pinagpala niyo na po ng inyong kapangyarihan upang manaig sa lahat ng mga pagsubok na ito, sapagkat kami nangagwagina dahil lang kay Kristo. Father, healing and physical strength, and as well as spiritual strength to be firm in the faith. Ang sabi na inyong salita, Beloved, I wish above all things that you may prosper in everything, be in health as your soul prospers. Thank you so much, Lord. Sa iyong biyay at pagpapala sa bawat isang kailangan at higit na nagtitiwala sa iyo, at sa hindi pa mananampalataya, Lord, open up the doors of their hearts. Help them to open up that door also for you to come in, to get through their life. And those who would have the Lord Jesus Christ in their life at hindi pa po kayo nakapag open ang inyong mga puso para kay Kristo, tayo manalangin saglit. Yumuko tayo sa harapan ng Panginoon, wherever you are, and if you are driving, if you can just stop somewhere, pull over your car to the side of the road if it is safe. But if not, just continue driving. Fix your eyes on the road, but your heart and your ears unto the Lord. Okay? Sabihin natin, Lord Jesus, I thank you for you have come to be the Savior and Redeemer of mankind. I know that I have sinned against you and against the Word of God. So I believe, Lord, that you suffered and died under Pontius Pilate. You were crucified for me so that I can be redeemed by the precious blood that you have shed on that cross. Thank you for loving me and thank you for your grace. So I surrender my life to you and back to you. Please forgive me of all my sins. Then on before in my life and today, cleanse me and purify me by your precious blood and by the power of the Holy Spirit of fire. Set me apart, Lord. And I thank you for giving me such forgiveness of my sins and the hope of a brand new life. I receive it today. And thank you for this life that you have changed now. Thank you for the eternal life and thank you for all the blessings in life that I will now receive from you. Bless my family and my relatives as well, that they should also open up their hearts for you, Lord. Please write my name in the book of life in heaven and allow me to serve you because I am grateful to you for all that you have done for my sake. Thank you, Lord Jesus. And I thank God the Father for you and in your name. And thank you, Holy Spirit, for your power, for your conviction, and your presence that will dwell in me for all the rest of my life. In Jesus' mighty name, I bring you back the glory and the honor. Amen. Kaibigan, kung pinapanalangin mo yung prayer na yon, congratulations. Ikaw ngayon ay anak ng Diyos. Ikaw ngayon ay bagong nilalang na. For those who are in Christ, 2 Corinthians 5:17, have become brand new persons. The old has gone, the new has come. Live out in a brand new kind of life. Live out in a brand new kind of hope. Live out in a brand new kind of a person and perspective. And a brand new kind of motivation. You will be strengthened every day. Keep on hungering for the Word of God. Read the Word of God. Believe in the Lord. And begin to pray with all of your heart. And believe. And believe. Whatever thing you may ask in the Lord, believe in your heart that He has already given that what you request. And then it shall be given to you. Salamat po mga kapatid. In Jesus' name, amen. Sister Marilyn Lingatong, thank you so much. Sister Rosumpoco, Sister May Medrano Parocha, thank you so much. Sister Gina Esparagosa, Genethea Lomboy, wow, praise the Lord. I love to see your names here. Lydia San Miguel, praise the Lord. Mira Glenn Reyes, see my child, Pastora Joyce. Jesus Manahan, good evening po. Hallelujah. Thank you for your continued patronage with our devotion, evening and morning. Tomorrow morning, 4 o'clock, God willing, He will wake us up healthy and strong and we'll be able to have a devotion like this. Roy Barabona, kamusta sila, Sister Maris? Novi Hubag sa Singuay. Yan. Bianca Michelle Bourbon. Arlwi Ortega. Shalom. Andring Sadora. Charles, good evening. Charles Kuncon, are you in Vietnam, sir? Ah, maganda yung balita ang sinabi mo. Mayroon kang life group sa Vietnam. God bless you. Naway, gamitin ng Panginoon ang iyong buhay. Princess Janet Valeroso Lazaro, hallelujah. Oh, si Enric, nanonood. Si Brother Money Besita, ang anak kong isa, si Tetel Nieves. Vivian Manuel from Tundo, praise God. Julius Castillo, you are watching. Please pray my place in Davao. My family is there. Sabi signal number 5 na daw ang bagyong si Chedeng. Praise the Lord. Walang kahangin-hangin yan ngayon. Pipigilan ng Holy Spirit. Charlie Flores, praise God. Oh Lord, thank you so much. Good evening, Pastor. Antay ko pong broadcast ninyo before going to bed. Nakaka-addict po makinig sa Word of God. Yeah, because the Word of God is life. If you stop taking in the Word of God, it will, you know, in-house in our hearts and minds some troubles and burdens. Brother Benji Beltran, who is working with the House of the Representatives. Good evening, Joseph Leite. All right. Thank you so much. Mayang gabi, Pastor Bob, watching here in my room before I sleep. It is now my habit. Praise the Lord. Blessed and victorious evening, Pastor Bob. Thank you, Lord, for using you mightily and powerfully for His kingdom. Watching, God bless. God bless you too. Doctora Ludi Dakel Martin, glory to God. Hallelujah. Wow, it's so nice to see you here. Brother, Witty Robusto Kabugnason, kumusta dyan sir sa Malaybalay Bukidnon, Mindanao? Si Darren Mendoza, thank you po Pastor, yes. Brother Howard Bongkayaw, ang atin pong musician sa Word of Hope Manila na working in the Middle East and he is watching. Armando Jose Lacson, you are watching sir, God bless you. Si Mikey Encisa, regular na po ang ating sister. Ate Liwanag Linang, hello. Si Ann Fowler Sienes, hello. Praise God, you are all here. Jingboy Atonin is watching. Praise God. Janet Valeroso, yeah. Lancero, J. Lord Dumlao, sir, you are watching. Arjun Birami Lepon, are you in Mindanao? Praise God, praise God. Noel Obregon, you're watching. Restivali Paran Kabugnason from Mindanao. Doctora Elia Tejada from the United States of America. Oh, Lord. Mary Gallagher from the United States of America. Norilyn Santiago, you're watching. Joe Mark Lidera, nasa kabila lang ng Puresa. Vince Bamba in Quezon City. My classmate sa Marikina, Terry Broquesa, Pastora Terry. Sister Agnes Formentera Montehermoso from Australia. Oh my God! Brother Glenn Balista, I believe, nasa Bulacan. It's already 10 o'clock in the evening and 37 minutes. God bless you. Shalom. See you tomorrow morning. And please continue to pray for us so that we can do this live broadcast every day, twice a day. But I have some kind of prayer that, you know, for me to become more effective for us this day of hope in Jesus Christ live, become more effective. We are looking for a place to have for our, to develop that as our broadcast station, to make that as my studio. And God willing, this will become a worldwide broadcasting program. God is good, and there are so many people who needs the Lord. And it saddens my heart that there are those so many big number of people doesn't have any more opportunity to read the Bible because of their busyness. But I will not encourage you that in the prevalence of smartphones, you can just go to the website. If you are using an Android smartphone, open up your Google Play Store and type in there in the search bar offline Bible application. At lalabas lahat yon, libre yon. Mag-download ho kayo. At kung meron ho kayong mahigit ang mga bookstore, kahit national bookstore locally, or sa mga book sale, hanap po kayo ng mga Bible. Mas maganda rin ho yung meron kayong physical, literal, hard copy ng Bible. Okay? And also, if you are using an iOS, iPhone, Apple iPhones, or iPad, iOS operated, pumunta po kayo ng Safari. Okay? Punta kayo ng Safari, mag-type kayo doon ng free offline Bible apps. Bakit kailangan offline? Para pag na-download niyo po yung application na yon at napili niyo yung mga modules, mga books na libre doon. At gaya ko, I spend money to buy books electronically, and then anumang gadget ko, Android man yan or Apple, sinisync ko sila, magkapareho sila ng application ngayon. So anuman yung mayroong power at anuman yung lowbat, yung may power, mabubuksan ko. Alright? Kahit saan ako magpunta, bukod pa sa aking physical Bible na kung makikita ninyo na sa aking likuran, the previous broadcast nakita ninyo sa aking file. Alright? So salamat sa Panginoon. See you tomorrow. God bless you. And make yourself be available in absorbing and listening, and also pondering, so that we can apply the Word of God and the principles of God for our life, so that we're gonna become fruitful, achieving, fulfilling, and we're gonna be elevated, promoted, and progressing. And soon, you can be able to fly high and soaring with the wings of the power of God by the mighty power of the Holy Spirit in your life, in your family. God bless you. Good evening. Amen. Who is this one who says matagal na?